the coronavirus and that key decision that will now affect millions of vaccinated Americans. The CDC director today signing off on a third dose of the Pfizer or Moderna vaccines to protect millions of immunocompromised people from the Delta variant. Dr. Rochelle Walensky calling it an important step to help protect millions with weakened immune systems. She did address the question many have, will we soon see this for the general population? And tonight, the worsening situation in several states, more than 80,000 patients hospitalized in the U.S. now. Louisiana reporting its highest number of hospitalizations since the start of the pandemic. And tonight, the alarming new headline out of Dallas, they have now run out of ICU beds for children. And with the school year just starting in many parts of the country, already more than 10,000 students and teachers are quarantined for exposure to the virus. Chicago tonight, now among the major cities requiring all public school teachers and staff to be fully vaccinated. Our team with EMS workers in parts of Texas going door to door providing vaccinations. And with the Delta variant sweeping through so many states, the U.S. vaccination rate is now increasing. More than 900,000 shots administered in just 24 hours. More than 69% of people 12 and older now receiving their first shot. But we start tonight with the new approval this evening for a booster shot, a third shot for millions of Americans. ABC's Marcus Moore leading us off tonight from Texas.
Tonight, the CDC recommending vaccine booster shots for 7 million Americans with weakened immune systems. The goal, to help boost immunity for people who may not have gotten enough protection from their first two Moderna or Pfizer shots. Cancer survivor Jerry McLaughlin got both Pfizer shots, but doctors at the University of Pittsburgh still couldn't detect she had antibodies, so she got a third shot today.
I'm just so relieved, not only for myself, but for the thousands of other patients that will now have the opportunity to get the booster shot.
The immunocompromised, like cancer and transplant patients, face greater risks. One study shows the chance of a vaccinated transplant patient getting a breakthrough infection is 82 times higher, and the risk of hospitalization or death is 485 times higher. Dr. Anthony Fauci telling David they're now studying real-time data on everyone else, tracking how much immunity tapers over time before determining if and when the general population will get boosters.
Dr. Fauci, obviously people at home are going to wonder, is everyone else next?
What we're talking about is making a decision based on real data. And as soon as we find out that we will need to have to booster people, we're going to be ready to do it right away. That's really what the plan is.
The CDC director saying late today, the CDC does not recommend additional doses or booster shots for any other population at this time. With 80,000 COVID patients, American hospitals across the South are sounding the alarm. In the last 4 days, Mississippi has seen younger unvaccinated patients die.
We've lost four healthy people in their 20s, two of whom were pregnant, zero vaccinated.
San Antonio, Texas, briefly running out of ambulances. Dallas running out of pediatric ICU beds.
In Dallas, we have zero ICU beds left for children. That means if your child's in a car wreck, or more likely, if they have COVID and need an ICU bed, we don't have one. Your child will wait for another child to die. Your child will just not get on the ventilator.
A Texas family is mourning the loss of 12-year-old Rylan Dietch. They say he was healthy, but when Rylan got COVID, his mom tells Bluebonnet News he declined quickly, passing away within days. In Corpus Christi, EMS crews are now racing to get more people vaccinated.
Feel it?
Yeah.
It's done.
Okay, that was another
one. We were there as they went door to door giving shots to kids like 13-year-old Derek Liao.
I feel like you should still wear your mask even if you have both of your shots.
Today, Chicago and Los Angeles mandating vaccines for teachers. With schools reopening, more than 10,000 students and teachers across 14 states are now quarantined for exposure to the virus.
My child, my choice.
But some parents across the country are pushing back against mask rules.
Parents should have the right to govern their own children.
In Broward County, Florida, schools are requiring masks and defying the governor's order. Just days before the new school year, officials report three members of the teaching staff died of COVID in just 36 hours.
And Marcus Moore with us live tonight from Dallas. And Marcus, I know the CDC director is also explaining when the immunocompromised should actually get this third shot.
Yeah, David, the CDC director recommends that third shot be given at least 4 weeks after the second, and that is preferably the same vaccine. This recommendation coming just 24 hours after Dr. Fauci told us they are studying this for everyone else, looking at real-time data to see how immunity wanes over time and looking at whether everyone else will need a booster shot at some point. David.
Yeah, we'll certainly be watching this in the weeks to come. Marcus, thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.